New details on the Russia investigation. House Speaker Paul Ryan says this morning he does not agree with President Trump and how President Trump has described former FBI Director James Comey. He does not, Paul Ryan, does not think the former FBI director is a nut job. Take a listen.
The former FBI Director Jim Comey, does it concern you that the president referred to the former FBI Director as a nut job?
Yeah, I don't agree with that, and he's not. I like Jim Comey. You know, I know that there are people who are on both sides of the aisle concerned about decisions he made. I think he was put into an impossible position.
With me now, Caroline Polisi. She's a federal and white-collar criminal defense attorney. Michael Balboni is here. He's a former New York State Homeland Security Director and Senior Fellow at the Homeland Security Policy Institute. That's a long title, Michael. Peter Beinart, Senior Political Commentator, Contributing Editor for The Atlantic, and Joe Borelli is a Republican New York City Councilman. Thank you for having the shortest title, Joe. I really appreciate it. I have no title, thank God. Okay, Michael, let's talk about Jim Comey. Paul Ryan does not agree with the description that Jim Comey is a nut job. I don't think this man would agree with it either. He's a friend of Jim Comey's. He spoke to Anderson Cooper. And here is what this friend of Jim Comey's said to Anderson and what he's thinking about as Jim Comey prepares to testify publicly. Listen to this.
I thought it was interesting and very telling that he declined an opportunity to tell his story in private. He clearly wants to do it in a public setting. And I interpret.
Right, he was asked to testify in private and he said no, so now it's going to be public.
Right, and I think that's a reflection of the fact that this is a guy with a story to tell. I think if I were Donald Trump, that would scare me a lot.
Do you agree with this guy? Do you think the president should be scared of the fact that Jim Comey is going to testify?
I think that you got to go back to what the reputation for Comey is. If you talk to police officers, you
and
talk
honestly,
to...
honestly, it's different depending on who you talk to, but I want to know your opinion.
Well, I think that he's a guy who's shown his independence. He did. I agree with the speaker. He was in an impossible position on both last election and now. So I think he has something to say. He wants to say it publicly. I don't think that that's going to be a great thing for the sitting president right now.
Hmm. And you have something to say, Joe, about that?
At some point, this Comey thing is starting to turn into the plot of The Usual Suspects, where we all speak about the villain in terms of who's speaking about him, friends, and his father comes out.
Who's Kaiser Soze?
Right, who is Kaiser Soze? But no one has actually heard anything from James Comey except the complete contradictory statements for what the media is supposing.
Wait, what are you saying? Well, I can't imagine, and look, I can be proven wrong every day, but I can't imagine this friend of Jim Comey's is out speaking if Jim Comey didn't want him out speaking.
Right, but keep in mind with the comments of whether he was obstructing justice, where you have on record now the third, I mean, with Brennan now the third, I think, high-level official under oath saying that this didn't happen, yet we're relying on these friends, the father of James Comey is literally a source now for how James Comey thinks.
Well, Brennan Brennan's not at the FBI, hasn't even been in the administration, right? If James Comey comes out and says, Donald Trump never pressured me to stop the Russia investigation, then Donald Trump will be okay. Right. If James Comey says, actually, Donald Trump several times tried to get me to stop the Russia investigation, and by the way, I took notes on those at the time, and I can show you,
right,
then Donald Trump will be in trouble because Donald Trump is known across the aisle as a pathological liar, and not that many people are going to accept his word over James Comey's, especially if Comey has notes.
Well, and here's my question about the notes and about the testimony in general, Caroline, and you can give me your opinion on this. There has been a lot of talk of how much Jim Comey's going to be able to say, especially with now that there's special counsel, the whole other element of investigation going on. What do you think? Do you think he can say it? Just how?
Absolutely. I mean, this man is fighting for his life at this point. He's up there. He's going to he's made a statement. He doesn't want to testify behind closed doors. He wants to go publicly. He wants to get this all out there. This is going to be the largest piece of the puzzle in that obstruction of justice charge, potentially in this mosaic we've all been talking about. It's the biggest piece of that puzzle, and he has to defend himself, and he has every right to do so.
So let me also ask you this, the new element of it that we're kind of learning. The president is, we can call it staffing up a little bit,
yes,
right? There's
yes.
a very clear expectation he's going to be bringing an outside counsel. Mark Cassowitz
yes.
is what everyone's talking about. What do you know about Cassowitz? What is his job going to be?
Well, Cassowitz is an extremely well-known civil litigator in New York. He's known for being aggressive, hard-hitting. He's a real bulldog in the courtroom. Interestingly enough, he's not so much of a criminal defense attorney. And so it's quite telling that Trump is bringing in Cassowitz. It's a clear pattern that he has of bringing in associates that are close to him. Clearly, he values
loyalty.
He's a long
history with him, and he trusts him, right?
He's valuing loyalty over perhaps experience in this arena. I will say that I've heard from several associates within the Cassowitz firm that a majority of the firm is now dedicated primarily to Trump-associated matters. I've also heard that the Cassowitz firm is having meetings with Michael Cohen, a former personal attorney with Trump. So
right.
Clearly,
who's still connected with President Trump.
Absolutely. So clearly, they're getting a strategy here. They're forming their war room, and he's taking this quite seriously. And they're going to mount a robust defense,
as should be expected. Joe, an additional element when you talk about a war room is now these reports that the White House is looking kind of for when you talk about a war room, like crisis communication strategy and what they're going to do defend the president against these Russia allegations. One person that has been coming up as a possibility of kind of leading that front is Corey Lewandowski, the president's former campaign manager. Do you think that's a smart move to bring Corey in?
Look, whether it's a smart move will play out, but certainly someone like Corey Lewandowski is a person who the president has gone to even after he was fired. I mean, look at Corey Lewandowski. I mean, he's someone who the president fired and still came out here day and night to support him on national television. I think the president views him as someone who took scant resources and had a revolution of the Republican Party and set the stage for the biggest political upset. Whether, you know, there's some rumors that Ivanka and Jared may not like him, and that might be true, but, you know, this is not about palace intrigue for the president. I think this is about getting people who he trusts to build a team around to defend against potential charges.
The problem that he has is that a crisis communications team has to tell a story, right? Mm-hmm. And what we've seen again and again and again is that Trump's aides go out and tell a story, and then Trump contradicts that story himself. None of this is going to work, no matter who he has.
No matter how great the
unless
strategy
he can show the discipline to get on the same page as his own advisors.
That's very interesting, Mike. I want to just final topic. I want to get your take on Michael. There's now word that the president is basically wants to start from scratch on his search for a new FBI director. I mean, just last week, the president said that he was getting very close to making an announcement very soon, and there was a clear front runner from all the reporting that it was former Senator Joe Lieberman. What do you think happened behind the scenes that they're now starting from scratch? What do you think?
Well, I think what the president has done is he's taken a look at what the profiles are out there. He's seen whether it meshes within his idea of what the director of the FBI should be. What's really important, though, is for everybody to understand this shouldn't be a popularity contest. The next FBI director should be somebody who will lead with vision.
It's kind of how he runs this, though, right? He ran it kind of, that's the way he kind of ran it with the pick for Secretary of State. And, you know, it seems
like
that's
a reality TV show, basically.
I mean, look.
True, but, you know, that everybody is always.
You're saying don't do that.
Don't do that here. But also, you have to give him credit. I mean, some of the guys that the administration has picked have been very high quality people, and he may find that here. And so what you have to do is you have to think about what the mission is. You know, remember, it's a 10-year term. That was done after J. Edgar Hoover served for too long. But you're supposed to have some independence, and you're supposed to be the person who's going to take on the tough topics and not be bullied. So you need somebody with a really strong personality. Now, a president with a really strong personality may not see that trait as that easy to reconcile. That's a part of the problem here.
Yeah, that 10-year term ended a little. Sometimes, there you go. Asterisks, sometimes. Great to see you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you.